bullshit.
Good morning. Yes, I'm at a hotel. So I decided not to go camping because the campsite was, it was first come, first serve lakeside. So I wasn't gonna get lakeside anyway. And they also did not have firewood on site. And that's huge for me. It's, firewood's very unstable to try to carry on the back of a motorcycle. Even if I put it in my 50 liter dry bag, it would shift during the ride and that can be very dangerous. So I prefer to have it on site. And a lot of the times they'll just bring it to me, which is really kind of them. So today I'm actually just north of Duluth. If you are coming north of Duluth, make sure you have a hotel because I got the last hotel room that was under $350. So unless you're rich, and I'm not, just make sure you got plans. I kind of winged it and I was lucky to get this one. So I'm gonna go to Gooseberry Falls today and see where I get from there. Wanna come along? Yeah, you're coming. Supposed to rain today, starting at 2 o'clock. 90% chance of rain for the rest of the day and all night. So I think I'm gonna skip camping at Grand Marais. Sometimes you gotta pivot and drive through town, maybe have lunch there. It's supposed to be a pretty little town. And then I'm gonna head straight to Kakabeka Falls, just west of Thunder Bay, and then maybe stay in Thunder Bay and catch up with family. See you there. Well, it's actually afternoon. I just left Thunder Bay and I'm heading towards Nez Provincial Park to camp for the night. But there's a couple of sites I want to see along the way. And the first one is on Wemet Road, I think it's pronounced. It's Wemet Canyon. It's a suspension bridge that I'm going to walk over. It's supposed to be really beautiful. Can't wait to see it. But this road is looking a little dicey. We're gonna try it. I'm glad that it is not rainy, because apparently it's clay and it's just a mess in the rain. So we'll give it a go. Come along. That wasn't so bad. No one said anything about a giant effing hill. Ooh. Ooh. Oh my goodness. Did I mention I'm afraid of heights? Oh shoot. That was super fun. Let's go. Just arrived at the site. It's pretty nice. Just had some wood delivered. It was very kind of them. I'm gonna set up. Okay, let's put the tent together.
Follow the sun. Which way the wind blows when this day is done. Breathe, breathe in the air. Set your intentions. Dream with care. Tomorrow's a new day for everyone. Brand new moon, brand new sun.
Why does it always start raining when I'm camping? Thank you. So I forgot what day it is. I can't keep track anymore. But Nays Park is, look at this. It's just the most beautiful park, very rugged. They don't really maintain the beach. It's covered with driftwood and just, it's just wild. So it's so beautiful here. The birds that I saw this morning, I had a great sleep last night. So today's plan is I'm heading to, I think it's Bachuacha Bay or Pancake Provincial Park. I'm going to stop in Wawa on the way, and I'm going to go see the pictographs, the painted rocks. I'll show you all that stuff when I get there.
I don't need another reason for my dreams to replace me. I let my bank account control my mood swings. My left arm's broke.
Okay, we're in Wawa. It has been raining since I left Marathon, and if the weather doesn't improve, I might have to change plans again. Otherwise, I've got some sightseeing to do, and I really want to camp at Pancake Bay tonight. So we'll see how it goes. Absolutely gorgeous, but you can't really access them because they're on a steep shelf, so the only way to really see them is by kayak. But man, that walk was worth it. Beautiful view, beautiful pathways. You should definitely try it. This is bullshit. All right, it's been raining all day, and it's supposed to rain all night, and I'm soaking wet, and my gear is wet again. I was really, really, really hoping to camp at Pancake Bay, because I know it's beautiful, but the weather is just not cooperating, and it will be no fun, so maybe next time around. So I'm going to head straight through the Sioux. It's about another hour and a half's ride. I'm going to be staying at the same hotel, hopefully, that I booked or that I stayed in the first time I came out, and after that, there's no more camping. I'm sort of heading home. So this is the end of my loop. I got a cute little cottage in Bruce Mines that I'm gonna stay at, and I'm hoping if the weather holds, I'll be able to ride from Thessalon up Highway 129, which is also known as the Canadian Tail of the Dragon. I'm hoping to do some twisties there and then make my way through Sudbury and down south and back home. Catch up with you later. So this is what I'm dealing with today. Rain's pretty heavy right now, but it's supposed to lighten up a little later and maybe even stop for a little bit, I'm hoping. Anyway, I'm heading to a little cottage on Lake Huron today as part of my planned ride home. So maybe I'll just buy myself a good book and snuggle up and ride out the rain. Can't stop, won't stop.
This day is done. Breathe, breathe in the air. Set your intentions. Dream with care. Tomorrow's a new day for everyone. And a brand new moon. Brand new sun.
Good morning. It's an early one. Getting papped up early because I am trying to outrun this. At least I'm not riding into it. Anyway, the only thing about leaving early is the animals on the road. So I got to be extra careful. Do you want to come? Too late, you're coming.
Salvation Army band played, and the children drank lemonade, and the morning lasted all day, all day. And through an open window came, like Sinatra in a younger day, pushing the town away.
So far so good. I got lots of room in my luggage because I'm wearing all my clothes. It's cold.
And everyone else came down.
to listen. He said in winter 1963, it felt like the world would freeze.
Good morning. Final day, 14 days, 3,200 kilometers. Made some new friends, saw some family, met up with some old friends I hadn't seen for a while. The weather wasn't cooperating the last few days, but today is a beautiful day, so I won't need this, pack that away. But it doesn't matter, I had a great time. Don't wait for somebody to go on an adventure with you that you want to go on. Just go do it.